The Unity version and Core Assets Package version I'll be using in this video is as follows. I choose to use Unity 5.5 because it takes a while before Leap Motion updates their assets to match Unity's latest version, which is currently 5. Here I have a new project and I've just imported the Unity Core Assets version 4.1.6. I'll first make a copy of Leap Hands Demo Desktop Scene, found under Leap Motion Scenes in the Project tab. I'll call it Extended Finger Detector Script, or Detector Scene. Unity offers many types of detectors, but in this video, I'll cover the Extended Finger Detector, which is basically just a script. As the name suggests, the extended finger detector allows us to perform an action when the fingers on our hand are either extended or not extended. First, I'll add the extended finger detector script to the rigid round hand R game object in the scene. So now rigid round hand underscore R should have the extended finger detector as a component. First, let's take a look at the hand model option in the script. Here it is set to rigid round hand R. This field specifies which hand this script will track. Now this field was set automatically because we added the detector script to a hand model object. If we added this to a non-hand model object, we would have to set this manually ourselves. Now let's look at the finger state section. Here we can specify under what conditions the onActivate Unity event will trigger. I'm going to set it so that onActivate will trigger when my index, middle, ring, and pinky fingers are extended. This will be akin to shooting a weapon in a game. I'll leave the thumb as either. So the moment one of these conditions are not met, the on deactivate Unity event will trigger. And the moment all these conditions are satisfied, the on activate Unity event will trigger. I'll demonstrate what the min and max finger counts do later in this video. Now the on activate and on deactivate need some functions to call when they are triggered. I've created a script called print message. So this script has two functions. First one is called print activate message, and basically we'll just print the word activated. And the other one is called print deactivated message, and it prints the word deactivated to the console. And we will add these under their respective Unity events. So under onActivate, I'm going to find the rigid round hand R object. And I'm going to set it to the, I have to edit a component still. And I'll go to print message and print activate message. Then I'll go to on deactivate and do the same thing. Print message, print deactivate message. So now let's play the game. And as you can see, when I open my hands, activated, when I close, deactivated, and the numbers just keep increasing as I do this action over and over again. You can see that at the tips of my fingertips, there are these small spheres that are either green or red. Green means they are in the correct position, and red means they are not in the correct position. And those positions are what you put in the finger states. So I think these are bugged right now because all the fingers except for my thumb should have a green sphere because they are activated or they are in the correct position. But you know, regardless, it still does work. Activated and undeactivated are working as intended, as you can see in the console. Yeah. So the last two fingers do change. Everything is red, but when I open it, only the last two are being marked, or my ring finger and pinky are being marked as in the correct position or in the correct state.